Hello everyone, welcome back to the Rasa Masterclass. In the previous episodes, we covered how you can enable your assistant to understand user inputs by building NLU models. Now, let's talk about the dialogue management and how you can enable your assistant to respond and drive the conversation while keeping the context. When we spoke about five levels of assistants, we discussed that, at the moment, the most popular approach to build conversational assistants in the industry is using a set of rules or a state machine. This approach makes it quite easy to handle the happy path, the situations where the users perfectly follow the conversation predefined by an assistant. However, things get messy once users drift from that path. Why it happens? Well, it's impossible to write rules for every possible dialogue turn. And once users drift from the happy path, which sooner or later happens with real users, a bot breaks, which results in quite a disappointing user experience. In addition to this, rule-based assistants are quite difficult to work with when things get big, because huge sets of rules are difficult to manage, maintain, and debug. Rasa takes a completely different approach on dialogue management. Instead of creating rules and enforcing them on the users, it uses machine learning to learn the conversational patterns from the example conversational data and predicts how an assistant should respond in a specific situation based on the context, the history of the conversation, and other details. The component responsible for dialogue management in Rasa is called Core. When developing conversational AI assistants with Rasa, everything starts with training data. In dialogue management, this data is called stories. An example conversations between the user and an assistant written in a specific format. That format is quite simple. User inputs are expressed as corresponding intents and entities, while the responses of an assistant are expressed as action names. Let's take a look at the actual example. A story starts with a double hashtag, which marks the name of the story. It's not mandatory to write the names for the stories, but it makes the debugging much easier. For the same reason, it is recommended to provide descriptive story names, something that would describe what an example conversation is about. You will always need more than one story to train the model. The end of one story is marked with a new line, and then a new story starts again with a double hashtag. Messages sent by the user are shown as lines starting with the asterisk symbol in the following format. The user inputs are expressed as entity labels, the same as defined in the NLU training data, and in the curly brackets, the extracted entity should be defined by providing the entity name and the entity value. As you can see, training stories don't have to include the actual text of user messages. Instead, you can leverage the output of the NLU model, intents and entities. It's important to include the entities to your training stories because both pieces of information, intents and entities, are used to predict the next action of the assistant. The responses of the assistant are expressed as action names. You can think of them as labels. They are shown as lines starting with a hyphen and contain the name of the action. Overall, there are two types of actions you can use in Rasa, utterances and custom actions. Utterances are hard-coded messages that a bot can respond with. Custom actions, on the other hand, can involve some custom code that can be executed. Now, let's move on to a more practical part, creating some training data for our Medicare locator assistant. In the episode called Creating the NLU Training Data, we wrote the most common conversations which we expect the users to have with our assistant. We use them as a basis of our NLU training data, and we can use them again to start creating some training stories for the dialogue management model. The training stories are typically saved in the project directory called data within the file called stories.md. Since we initially created the project using Rasa init function, what you find here are stories used to train the moodbot, an example assistant which gets built using this command. Let's add the Medicare locator assistant stories here and start with the first conversation. First, let's name the story. Search Hospital Happy Path sounds like a good title here, since the user provides all necessary information and the conversation goes as expected. User inputs are expressed as corresponding intents, which we use to train the NLU model. And we can give the names to response actions. For example, the response where an assistant responds with a greeting can be called utterance greet. The user inputs, which contain some entities, in this example we have two of them, facility type and location, should have those entities specified in the stories as well. The response is where an assistant runs some kind of backend integrations to create the response. For example, searching the database for the closest hospital or making an API call should start with a prefix action. And finally, the story for this conversation ends with the user saying thank you and an assistant responding with a goodbye. For the model to learn, we need more than one training story, so let's write a training story for the second conversation as well. Here, the user didn't provide their location immediately. That's why we named the story search hospital plus location to reflect the main user queries. In general, this story is similar to the previous one. The main difference is that the assistant asks for user's location using an action utterance ask location, and the user provides their information, which is expressed using a specific intent in form. Dialogue management models, just like NLU, require a set of diverse training examples. That's why the stories in your training data file should cover different dialogue turns. While there is no specific rule for how many training examples you need to build a good model, an important thing to remember is that your assistant should start learning from real users as soon as possible. The best advice I can give you here is to focus on building a simple application first. Build an assistant which can handle the happy path quite well and maybe some additional deviations from the happy path, and give your assistant to real users as soon as you can, because the conversations they are going to generate while talking to your assistant is the best training data you can possibly get. We will cover the process of sharing your assistant with real users, collecting the conversations and using them to improve your assistant in the later stages of the masterclass, so stay tuned for that. There are a few additional components necessary to train the dialogue manager models. We will cover them in the next episodes of the Rasa Masterclass. Until then, I would like to encourage you to spend more time creating example training stories for the Medicare locator assistant. Start with writing down the actual conversations with different dialogue turns and then convert them into the Rasa format. I'm saying goodbye for now, but I'll see you in the next episode of the Rasa Masterclass, where we will continue working on the dialogue manager models.